The Thermalright TL-C12B V2 is a highly affordable fan since it is bundled with the Peerless Assassin 140, along with another 140mm fan, with the total cost of this cooler not exceeding $40. So far, Thermalright doesn't offer this fan as a standalone product, but this didn't prevent me from fully evaluating. Don't expect RGB lighting or the daisy chain option in such an inexpensive product. The latter option might also be missing since Thermalright already includes a PWM splitter in the PA140 bundle. The TL-C12B V2 achieves an impressive airflow rating in the Cybernetics PHY scale and a less impressive static pressure rating. The fan has 9 blades to produce more airflow. The more blades, the wider the moving surface area that interacts with the air. Hence, the fan pushes more air. The blade's angle, shape, and speed are major airflow factors. I use a fan performance measurement apparatus to evaluate cooling fans. This is a highly sophisticated scientific instrument made in Taiwan by Longwind. Besides the Longwind machine, I also use a hemianechoic chamber and a highly sophisticated and super expensive noise analyzer by Bruel and Kerr. Although its maximum speed is low, this doesn't prevent the fan from achieving high maximum airflow readings. On the contrary, its static pressure is low. Its power consumption is low, but there is still a notable difference from the Noctua NF F12, which has the same maximum speed. Noise output is low, 20% fan speed. Ignore the 50Hz noise from the mains grid. The 100Hz and 125Hz frequencies stand out. 50% fan speed, peak frequency 400Hz. 70% fan speed, peak frequency 800Hz. Full speed, peak frequency 630Hz. I have recorded these signals, but please keep in mind that I've enabled automatic gain control to make it easier for you to reproduce them. decibels noise output, low speed, top airflow, low static pressure, average power consumption. 25 decibels, low speed, top airflow, low static pressure, average power consumption. 30 decibels, low speed, top airflow, low static pressure, low power consumption. Advertised versus real performance. In this table, red means bad, blue means good. The fan speed, power consumption and airflow are better than advertised. The opposite is true for static pressure and noise output. It's a shame that Thermalright doesn't offer the TL-C12B V2 as a standalone product, but only bundled with a PA140 cooler. This is a high airflow fan, rated titanium in the Cybernetics PHY fan rating system, but only bronze in static pressure. This fan's design focuses on airflow, leaving static pressure far behind, so I wonder how the PA140 cooler would perform with a more balanced fan, offering increased static pressure. In any case, the TL-C12B V2 is ideal if you need high airflow, for example for chassis use. Given the low price of the PA140 cooler, I expect the TL-C12B V2 to be equally affordable, but there is no relevant information from Thermalight whether it will provide it as a standalone product. Let's now look at 25 decibels noise normalized performance. I chose 25 decibels because it is low enough not to annoy most users and high enough to allow for speeds that offer decent airflow and static pressure performance. While it loses in static pressure, its airflow performance is top, achieving first place in the 25 decibels normalized noise chart. Given that most users cannot tolerate full fan speed noise, this low speed fan is ideal for most user scenarios where higher flow is desired. To check all alternative fan offerings, read my best cooling fans article on hwbusters.com before investing in new cooling solutions. You will also find this review on the same site.